Hey, everybody, it's a week in review.
I'm today in Wanago in kindergarten, and we're celebrating our 50 days with floats.
And we did other math stuff, and the number was 50.
Today in robotics, we had a guest speaker show us how robots in the real world work.
This week at Renaissance, we've been doing a dance unit in gym, so every day we go outside and work on our dancing.
Today is the fifth grade hoedown. Every class has their own like dance, and the parents are going to be there to watch us.
We're at Scales Elementary, and we're in the library, and we're doing augmented reality, and we are coloring birds that are coming to life on our iPad.
At Trinity this week, the third grade did Dance Dance Revolution.
We learned how to step the rhythm with the beat of the song and transfer our weight from one foot to another.
We are Heritage Elementary in third grade.
We're doing lots of hands-on stations.
We're doing a lot of rotations and a lot of multiplication sentences.
We're having a lot of fun and doing a lot of math.
Today in the STEM lab, we made it windows, and my favorite was a plastic paper, and it was transparent.
So this week at Centennial, the cosmetology students are face painting sugar skulls to celebrate Day of the Dead.
We're building a marshmallow structure, and then at the teacher's desk there's Jell-O that we're gonna put it on, and we're gonna shake it to see if our structure that we built can survive a earthquake.
In the life skills class, we made a brain with learned how to make brains with Play-Doh.
This week at Fairview Middle School, our history class had Officer Rogers come and talk to us about amendments.
Hi, I'm Megan Munson, the librarian at Jordan Elementary. We were lucky today to have author Nathan Hale come and visit our school and talk to our kiddos.
I'm here at Nolensville High School in Principles of Engineering, and we're using calipers to develop the wheels and axles of our motorized cars.
I'm in Lifetime Wellness, and we got the basics of doing tennis and the importance of exercise.
Today in Warrior, we are writing thank you notes and spreading kindness to people that we care about around the school.
We are in Ms. Runyon's class, and Elvis is in our building, and Elvis is in line. We are celebrating the fifth day of school.
Today was Pumpkin Day. At Mill Creek, we measured how tall the pumpkin was, and then we made a booklet, and then we took the seeds out.
Hi, my name is Meredith, and I'm in second grade, and today we did pumpkin math, and we got to weigh the pumpkin and count on the seeds, and after that, we got to make a jack-o'-lantern.
Change Makers is a project that we did in fifth grade, and we got to invite the parents and groups got to choose what was important in their world.
Hi, my name is Riley, and today I'm in fifth grade, and we're using manipulatives
to divide decimals by whole numbers.
Today in Ms. Ham's class, we are working on West Africa and their achievements.
Our early childcare 2 class got to take out the children, and they got to dress up for Halloween, and we went to different classes to collect candy for them.
This week at Hunter's Bend in the second grade, we made pumpkins into book characters.
We read a book, wrote a report, and we decorated our pumpkin to make it look like the book character.
Today at Lipscomb Elementary in third grade in science class, we made the tallest freestanding tower that we could.
In the engineering design process, our materials were a cup of toothpicks, a cup of marshmallows, and some candy corn.
We had pumpkin day, and we ate pumpkin snacks
and carved and painted a pumpkin.
We are doing a simulation of the impeachment trials for Andrew Jackson that never happened.
Today in Ms. French class, we did an experiment with Diet Coke and Mentos. When the Mentos were put in the Diet Coke, it exploded.
Three.
Today we are building a pumpkin stand. There's prizes for the least amount of money, the tallest, and the sturdiest stand.
It's Red Ribbon Week at Tulsa Station Middle School. We're decorating doors for drug awareness.
The fire department came today and taught us what to do in case of a fire, and I got to climb out of the window.
Today at Longview, we are examining how erosion changes the Earth's surface.
in Hillsborough's Book Fair, The Arctic Adventure. We've had fun helping kids find books to read and having so much to read.
Today, students are walking around the gym and talking to possible employers about employment opportunities and future chances to work for different companies.
Today we had a Halloween STEM challenge. We used popsicle spoons, rubber bands, and tape to make our catapults.
We used these little pumpkins to launch them out of our catapults at targets.
We're at Brentwood High School, and this is Honors English 3 Juniors, and we are doing an escape game. Edgar Allan Poe, Murder at the Rue Morgue, to see if we can get out of the morgue before the killer gets us.
This year at Crockett, we read Wish Tree by Katherine Applegate. Once we finished the book, we collaborated with the art department to create our very own Wish Tree installation art here in the library.
Today in Ms. Andrews' class, we were doing a lab. The lab was where we rolled balls down a ramp and saw which one was the fastest.
At Independence this past week, the Eagle's Nest went on a trick-or-treat, so let's go check it out.
Kenrose is celebrating Red Ribbon Week this week to remind students to make responsible and healthy choices.
And today, we get to dress up as book characters, and today, I'm Hermione Granger from Harry Potter.
And I am Louis Zamperini from Unbroken.
Today, we are tie-dyeing t-shirts, fifth grade, for physical and chemical changes for this upcoming party.
This week at Mill Creek, the Junior Thespian Society were making makeup scarves that Ms. Isom taught us so we can raise money to go to the Junior Theater Festival this January.
Today we had Storybook Character Dress-Up Day, and I am Narwhal Unicorn of the Sea.
And we had a parade to celebrate students who met their AR goals.
So we're using the electrical signal across the muscles we're amplifying that through the circuit board and with this TENS unit. And then that triggers the nervous system in Dr. Pantel's arm.
Yesterday in our band lesson, we saw a video of what happens in our body when we play an instrument.
Today we were at Spring Station Middle School in Mr. Landry's Social Studies class, and we're talking about the Constitutive Convention, and we just got done with a great debate.
We're talking about how slaves should be counted for Continental Congress, or they should be taxed.
It was a great week. Thanks for watching.
Oh, today we did a little Halloween trick-or-treating outing. This is a tradition that we have in our early childhood class that we get to do each and every year. We've been out and about on Halloween Day for probably the last 25, 30 years. It's a long-term tradition. We have dinosaurs and princesses, spiders, special ops.
Say thank you.
It's the excitement of the high school students and the faculty, the school, and especially the children, of course.
I can help y'all. $50.
Well, this is the Coliseum, so this is Summit High School school store.
We are a food operation, so we basically just sell food, like a concession stand sort of deal.
I'm the Coliseum manager, and yes, sir.
I'm in here every day simply because, you know, presidential duties, I guess.
We get to learn what it's like to be in the real world.
The ability to learn a lot more with this hands-on training than they could in the classroom.
Make sure when it's out, we order it, and what's selling the fastest, what we need to buy more of.
The French vanilla will sell fast, but sometimes the mocha really is variant.
We try to make it before we open the gate in the morning so that when somebody comes up and orders it, that we don't have to have them wait.
It really is variant. So we really never know how many mochas to make.
When one person's standing there waiting on something, you're trying to get other people's orders that might not want a coffee and still keep the line moving.
And we're just trying to get it figured out because some students, there is a miscommunication on how many to make at the beginning.
It's just part of that, working through that process of how many do you really make.
Even though we have said 4 French vanilla, 4 mocha.
And learn how to communicate with the people that you're working with and talk through that process and through that problem. It's exactly what they need to be doing.
Yeah, we do all kind of get along with each other.
Just going to a job from 9 to 5 a day doesn't have to be the most painful thing you ever have to do. I love that you can come in and brighten the place up with just a personality, with just a smile. That's all it really takes is to get somebody into a better mood.
He needs my help here.